Hi, my name is Katie Powers and I'm an ESRI instructor. Today we're going to look at how we can quickly and easily create a custom web app with ArcGIS Instant Apps. For today, I need to actually create a web app for some volunteers at Rocky Mountain National Park so they can find the trails that they will be repairing as well as some park resources and amenities. ArcGIS Instant Apps has actually a lot of templates to choose from, so I'm going to use the suggestions to help me narrow down my results. The first question is, what is our goal for the app? Well, we're looking to provide public information for our volunteers. What do we want to share? Well, we want to share proximity to the features within the park. And finally, what feature geometry type do we have? We're working with points and lines. I get three results, and I'm actually going to pick, I think, the nearby app for this particular web app. Let's give it a title. Let's give it a tag. And then let's go ahead and create our app. Okay. By default, with ArcGIS Instant Apps, you can actually create and configure the app through the Express settings. We're going to leave these on. I can tell the Express settings are on by looking in the top left-hand corner. But my first step in configuring my app is going to be to select my web map. I'm going to use a web map that I already created for the purposes of our volunteer work. Okay, my map looks good, so I'm going to head to the next step. Here, I can change things like the app title, as well as the title for introduction. Let's add a title for introduction. That title is added to the left-hand side panel of the app now. Let's head to step three. Here, it's going to ask me which layers I'd like to include in the app. And I want to actually include all of them, so I'm going to turn all of my layers on. Then under Map Extent, I'm going to turn on Use Layer Effects so that we can have a strong drop shadow with our features. Under Search Radius, I'm going to set the maximum search distance to 1 mile and the default distance to half a mile. I also need to change those search units to miles. With that, I'm ready to go to the next step. In step four, I'm going to turn on this layer list option. That way my volunteers can actually view the layers directly in the app. In step five, I'm going to make a few changes to the theme. Let's set our theme to forest, and let's take that layer list tool that we added and move it up to the top right-hand corner with the rest of our tools. From there, I'm all set and ready to publish. Everything's published, so let's launch our app so we can test it. To start, I'm actually going to search for a location called Lily Lake. So let's go to the top left and search for Lily Lake. The app is going to take us there and show us the features that are within a half a mile. If I take a look at my results, I have one picnic area, one restroom, two trailheads, and many trails to choose from. If I take a look at my trailheads, I'll see the two that resulted from my search. And I'm going to click on this Lily Lake Visitor Center trailhead. When I do that, in the app itself, I'll get a pop-up of information so I can learn more about the trailhead. And I can even go view more information from the National Park Service website to see if there are any hazards on the trail or any construction that I should be aware of. So it looks like our app is working well. Thanks for watching, everyone. Now you know how to quickly and easily create a custom app with ArcGIS Instant Apps.